Chemical weapon leak detected in Pueblo Depot. Going into this a little bit more, Joey B did a little thing on this, and so I thought I'd look into it a little bit more. Thanks, Joey. A monitoring crew has found a leak inside one of the igloos at the Pueblo Chemical Depot, where mustard agent is stored. The storage igloo contains 105 millimeter projectiles with chemical weapons inside, which date back more than 50 years. All the weapons are scheduled for destruction, and the plant to destroy them is under construction. This is a fairly common occurrence. When a leaking projectile is found, it is sealed in a special case until it can be destroyed. Okay, so these things have been around for over 50 years. Why haven't they been dealt with? Well, the Pueblo Chemical Depot demilitarization costs soar to $3.6 billion. This was just in April. The projected cost of destroying chemical weapons stored at the Pueblo Chemical Depot in Colorado has soared over time from $1 billion to $3.6 billion. The price tag for eliminating the aging stockpile of mustard blister agent-filled weapons at the Army installation does not include the expense of safeguarding the toxic material for decades or the home office costs for the agency in charge of the disposal process. The Army's Assembled Chemical Weapons Alternatives Initiative is managing construction of the chemical neutralization plants at Pueblo and the Bluegrass Army Depot in Kentucky. It will ultimately be in charge of the destruction effort at both sites. Pueblo anticipates disposing of its 2,600 tons of mustard agent between 2015 and 2017. Meanwhile, Bluegrass is scheduled to begin destroying its stockpile of 523 tons of nerve and blister agents in 2018 and to finish operations in 2021. Nearly a decade after the April 2012 cutoff point established by the Chemical Weapons Convention. So Why wouldn't they take care of this right away? Well, that's kind of a stupid question, knowing that our government would probably be very happy if this got loose and killed half of the, most of the state of Colorado. Oh God, I'm sorry. Don't let me get going here. While the Kentucky and Colorado depots were long expected to hold the last U.S. chemical arsenals to be destroyed, fluctuating funding levels and the Pentagon's 2005 demand for new disposal plant designs slowed the process. So all this money that was allocated, where did it go? Where did it go? So it's just stall tactics. This is just stall tactics. Stalling tactics. I can't talk. I'm sorry. Okay, one more. This is from the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute. This is from 2008. Dangerous unknowns. MBARI researcher points out lack of information on chemical weapons dumped in the sea. Large quantities of chemical weapons sit on the sea floor, slowly degrading and posing a hazard to fishers and ocean scientists who stumble upon these stockpiles. After World War II, between 46 and 72, many countries dumped these outdated chemical weapons on the seafloor. In 1972, they signed the London Convention for forbidding further ocean disposal. Although some disposal sites have been well studied, little is known about the exact location or contents of most disposal sites on the west coast of the United States. Chemical munitions used in World War II included mustard, LEWISITE, SARIN, and tabun. When these toxic agents are exposed to seawater, they can react to form additional harmful substances. LEWISITE, for example, could degrade to release arsenic near disposal sites. Brewer's report, published in the March 1, 2008 issue of Environmental Science and Technology, points out that chemical weapons in the ocean get little attention compared to chemical weapons disposed on the land. The ocean's always getting shortchanged. About 500 people around the world, mostly fishermen, have been injured by the weapons since 1946. Ocean scientists are increasingly exploring the collecting sample data from the seas and could easily come in contact with these chemicals. Off the Japanese East Coast, chemical weapon dump sites are small, shallow, close to shore, and contain large amounts of chemical weapons. The U.S. National Geospatial Intelligence Agency publishes charts of Japanese waters, but these do not include Japanese disposal sites. Many of these sites are poorly documented. Japanese fishermen have encountered the chemical agents at these sites, often with tragic results. In Italy, more than 200 fishermen were hospitalized between 1946 and 1966 after catching chemical weapon agents in their nets. The Italian government has since identified numerous chemical weapons sites in the Adriatic Sea. Many of these areas are routinely used for ocean research, despite the fact that sediments surrounding these sites contain mustard degradation products and local fish have lesions and contained elevated arsenic levels. There are 32 disposal sites off United States shores, most with poorly known contents. The locations and quantities of chemical weapons off the East U.S. coast were documented in 2006 article in the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists, but sites in the Pacific Ocean were not mentioned. Similarly, a 2000 report by the Congressional Research Service only listed one site off California, and this illustrates particularly acute lack of information about the sites off the California coast. This just happens to be right below beautiful Monterey Bay. Oh, God. Many of the U.S. sites are marked on nautical charts published by the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. However, for navigation during research cruises, many scientists rely on other tools, such as geophysical maps and satellite images, which don't note the sites. Okay, just kind of makes you sick. You know? And we thought we were going to get poisoned by Fukushima. We've already been fucked. Okay. I can't even read anymore. It's pretty obvious that nobody really cares. So I'll leave the links. If you want to do any more reading on this, please feel free. And if anybody can actually explain a little bit more about these discarded chemical weapons, because I didn't do my research on that as of yet, but I forgot to do that. Anyway, all is good, and as always, God bless.